Hello everyone, welcome back to Third Element Chain Tutorials. The lotus flower is one of the most ancient and deepest symbols of our planet, representing long life, health, honor, purity and good luck. Lotus flowers have been influential in cultures around the world, in ancient Egypt, India, Thailand and China, among others. So this is what we're going to be doing today. So let's create one. So I'm going to minimize this. And I'm inside Illustrator, and the first thing I want to do is select the ellipse tool and click and drag and create a shape like this. Next, select the direct selection tool, click here once, because I want you to see these points here that I have control handles. Now, what I want to do is I want to create on here and here, from the top and bottom, I want to create corner points, and a corner point is a point that doesn't have control handles. And for that I'm going to go under the pen tool and choose the convert anchor point tool. So click once here and here. Alright. Let's select this. It's going to make a duplicate of that. So Alt or Option. Click and drag and hold down the Shift key as you're dragging down. Zoom in. Marquee Zoom. Select this bottom petal. And tap the down arrow key on your keyboard. Select both. Make sure there's no fill, just a stroke. And go to the object menu and group them. And as you can see here, I have a group with these two paths. Okay, zoom out. I want these to be aligned to the artboard. So right here, I'm going to choose align to artboard, horizontally aligned. And vertically. Now, what I want to do is I want to create a lot of duplicates all around so we create the first shape of the flower. Now, there's a very powerful effect inside Illustrator, and that is under the Effect menu, Distort, Transform, Transform. Now, I want to transform this with duplicates of increments of 15 degrees. Of angle. And then I'm going to choose here preview. That's 15 degrees. And for copies, I'm going to just click here once and I'm going to tap my up arrow key to increase the number of copies. And at the same time, interactively, I'm looking at the result. And 11 copies does a trick. So click OK. Now, let's rename this. That would be petals, stroke, and fill. Now, we do have the stroke, but we don't have the fill. Now, this is an effect. So whatever I do to this petal here, let's say I stretch it a bit, the effect is carried through. So I'm going to undo this. So what I need to do is, I'm going to go to the object menu, expand appearance. And now I have multiple objects, which is going to help me paint this. All right. So I'm going to choose the live paint bucket. I'm going to double click, choose a color of my choice. Make sure this is selected. Let's zoom in a bit here. And again, still with the live paint bucket. Click. Oops. Let's make sure we have a color. Click and paint these overlapping areas. And here we go. All right. For now, I'm going to lock this layer, but I'm going to go back to it. So I'm going to create a new layer now, which I'm going to drop this underneath the petals and stroke. And I'm going to double click and rename this gradient circle. And so because it's a circle, let's zoom in a bit, I'm going to select the ellipse tool, Alt Shift, Option Shift on the Mac, and draw from the center. No need for stroke, just a fill. Let's make sure that this is horizontally aligned and vertically. And for that I'm going to use a gradient. This is the default gradient. I want my gradient to be radial, but I want to change the colors of this. And so I can have my swatches here, so I can click and drag and put this color right here. Now, this is a gradient slider, and these are the gradient stops. Here's the first stop and the last stop. And the color stops determine what colors appear inside the gradient. So I have from white to orange. Now, I'm going to click and move this right in the middle here. And to be precise, I'm going to type 50%. And then under the blank area here, I'm going to click and add another color stop, which I'm going to move it at the end. Take this color here and drag it around there. Another way you can do this is double click and choose white. Okay, so here we go. All right, I'm going to lock this one. Then I'm going to create a new layer. So I'm going to drag underneath here. And I'm going to rename this inner circle. Again, ellipse tool, Alt Shift, Option Shift on the Mac, click and drag from the center and create a circle. No need for gradient here, just to fill. But for this color, I'm going to use, actually, I can choose from the swatch palette here, just this orangey color. And also inside the appearance palette, which you can access this window from the appearance here, I want to have a stroke of like 2 pixels and a black stroke. Okay. Now, this circle here has a basic appearance, which means it's an object with a single fill and a single stroke and no effects applied to it. The moment you start adding more than one stroke or more than one fill and some effects to it, then the object has a complex appearance. And so I'm going to create one. I'm going to go to this flyout menu here and add a new stroke. I'm going to leave the stroke right here as it is. For this one, I'm going to increase the width of the stroke to 16 pixels. And also, I'm going to change the color of it. And the color I'm going to use is this, the same thing as the petals. Now, what happens here is that the thickness of the stroke is actually distributed evenly on either side of the path, as you can see here. It's right in the middle. So in Illustrator, every time you define a stroke with some thickness to it, that thickness gets evenly distributed along the center line of the path. In this example, I have 8 points of stroke distributed evenly. But what I want is, I want this stroke to sit to the outside. So I'm just going to click here once, align stroke to outside. There we go. So I'm going to lock this layer, I'm going to unlock that one. And as I mentioned before, I'm not done with this. I want to paint this, the rest of this, with white. And so I'm going to select the paint bucket. I'm going to choose white. I'm going to zoom even more. And click and keep dragging. And paint these overlapping areas with white. There we go. It's exactly what I wanted. Okay. All right, now, last thing we need to do is to create these outer petals. So, create a new layer, click and drag. Let's rename this outer petals. And then I'm going to go to the view menu, rulers. I'm going to show my rulers because I'm going to use one. I'm just going to drop it here and then align it horizontally because it will help me draw the outer petals. And so I'm going to select the pen tool. I'm going to click and drag. And then I'm going to hold the shift key and click and drag here. So I'm holding on the shift key as I do that. Something like that. You can also move this a little closer. Right, I don't need this. Here's if you see on this layer here, you have the path, which is this one, but you also have the guide. You can just delete the guide. And here's the path. Well, the path has no color, so inside the stroke, you can say like 1 pixel, but make sure it's black. Here it is. And then what I want to do is I want to mirror this to the other side. And so I'm going to select the reflect tool, double click, copy, and hold down the left arrow key on your keyboard to move this to the other side. I'm going to zoom in. Move this closer. And I'm going to select the direct selection tool and marquee select those two endpoints. What I need to do is I need to join them first and then average. So, object, path, join, object, path, average, both. And you might think, oh, it looks fine, no problem here, but if you click right here and click and drag with the direct selection tool, you will see that an additional path has been drawn between those two points. This is not what we're looking for, so I'm going to undo this. So Control-Z or Command-Z on the Mac. So what happens is this. If you try to join two non-coincident endpoints, which basically are anchor points that are not overlapping, then a path, Illustrator draws a path between those two points. So to avoid this, you need to average the location first and then join them. Still selected with marquee selection here. Object, path, average both. Object, path, join. Let's test this. It works pretty good. But I'm going to try and undo this one more time. And I want to show you a much quicker way to do it. And for that is a great shortcut. Again, marquee select those two endpoints. And the shortcut is Control, Shift, Alt, J on the PC. Command, Shift, Option, J on the Mac. So I'm holding down Control, Shift, Alt, J. And now I've done two of these commands at the same time. Okay, zoom out. Looks pretty good so far. I'm going to make those invisible, and I'm going to work on this one. I'm going to zoom in. I'm going to go to the Object menu, sorry, Edit menu, copy, edit, paste in front. And I have a copy right on top. You can see I have two paths here. So, Alt Shift Option Shift on the Mac, size this down, and then down arrow key on your keyboard to move this down. Zoom even more, select the pen tool, click here once, and then you're going to see a circle appearing right next to the pen tool. That means close the path. Do the same thing here and make those the other layers visible. Let's make sure it sits exactly where we want to. And move it right there. Okay, with this here, well, first let's color this. And so I'm going to use a gradient for that. And remember, Illustrator remembers the last gradient that I used, which is okay. I'm going to go to the swatches palette, and for this end last color stop, I'm just going to click and drag and put a color here. And that's what I want. Okay, let's make a duplicate of that. And I'm holding down the space bar to go up and down, left and right. So Alt or Option, click and drag, hold down the Shift key as you go. And then rotate this, hold down the Shift key, 45, 45, 45 degrees. And then move this up with your up arrow key. And let's zoom to make sure that we do a fine job here. And let me make sure I'm even accurate here. I have 1, 2. Let's go right here just to make sure. 1, 2. There we go. So now it's exactly even, the distance. All right. Select those two, hold down the Shift key, or you can just select from here. Okay. Object, group them together. And for one more time, I want to make a lot of duplicates. So again, back to the effect menu, distort transform, transform, increments with angle 15 degrees of angle here, so type 15, make sure you check the preview, place your mouse there and increase the number of copies, and we're going to see this results interactively. And I want 11 copies. I click OK. And we also created the auto pedals. The transform effect inside Illustrator is a very powerful tool that can help your creativity and speed up your work with great results. So just experiment with different shapes and paths. This concludes the lecture, and thank you for watching Third Elementor tutorials.